again, folks. This is Josh Bedsall, MrRVTech.com. In our last video, you saw us effectively remove a decal. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to install one. As you can see, we've replaced the J-wrap on this Montana due to a blowout. And our stripe here, obviously, needs to be replaced. So I've measured and cut and fit the decal to fit in that area. And to prepare your surface to take a decal, you need to use denatured alcohol, rubbing alcohol, some kind of a cleaner that's going to take any grease, oil, or dirt off of your surface. The tools required is just a basic spreader, plastic flexible spreader. You want to make sure it's clean and free of burrs, and some soapy water. It doesn't matter if it's Dawn dish liquid or car wash, it really doesn't matter. What you're going to do first is spray the area where you want to apply the decal. Get it soaking wet. Next, you want to carefully separate the backer from the decal itself. And as you do this, you want to keep it wet so it doesn't fold over and stick to itself or stick to your fingers. So a little bit at a time and continue to get the decal wet as you peel it. And this procedure applies to big decals, little decals, it doesn't matter. You're going to do them all the same way. You want to make sure everything is nice and wet when you do this. And I've marked my trim here to indicate my fitment so I know exactly where to put this when I stick it on the trailer. So I'm going to stick it up here. And it's kind of going to cling to the J-wrap and just sit there for me. And you can see with the soapy water, I'm able to move this decal and manipulate it into any place that I want to. So I'm going to take the edge of my decal and line it up. Line it up to my mark in the trim. Make sure it matches at the other end. Smooth it out. Now this is the key. A lot of people make the mistake of just start wiping this decal. If this was a wide decal or had a very large area and I just started wiping it, I would trap air bubbles and the soapy water underneath it in the center. So it's imperative that you always pull your water from the center out. And then I'm going to go from the center up. So in this case, I went up and down. You can go left or right from the center as long as you start in the center and work your way out, pushing those air bubbles, or in this case, soapy water bubbles, out from underneath the decal. Take the spreader, a little bit of force on it. Obviously, you don't want to dig into the backer or the decal itself. Now, we're going to press the pause button and have about a 15-minute time delay on this to let it set up and let that soak dry underneath. Then we'll come back and peel the backer off the decal and we're finished. Alright, so our 15-minute delay is up. Decal's been sitting on here for 15 minutes. I've wiped off all the soapy water. I'm just going to get this started. You'll notice as I peel this off, I'm not pulling straight out to get it off, because that can sometimes pull the decal off of the surface. So I want to pull into the backer as I remove it, and that won't disturb the vinyl below. Alright, if you want to grab a close-up, you'll see there's absolutely no bubbles or wrinkles in this decal. Nice and smooth. Alright, that's it. Now you can install your own decals. Minimal tools, minimal time, piece of cake. See you next time.